Hey guys, and welcome to yet another video. Now I know it's been long, but we won't do it again. We'll be regular from now. Now the main topic of this video is why I think the Galaxy S10 Plus, at the price it is right now, a better value than the OnePlus 7 Pro. So without any further ado, let's get started. So starting off, the most important factor for a lot of you guys out there is going to be pricing of the phones. So let's get the pricing out of the way. Now, because the S10 Plus starts with 8GB of RAM, I'm going to consider the price of the OnePlus 7 Pro that is 8GB. So when we look at the pricing, OnePlus 7 Pro, 8GB version at least, is priced at 52999, which is 53,000. While the Galaxy S10 Plus can be had in a few shops in India at like 60,000, which is brand new and sealed, not even used, that I'm talking about. So at that price, here are the reasons why I think S10 Plus is a better value for your money. Now the first thing is going to be the AKG pair of headphones that S10 Plus gives in this box. Now these pair of headphones are priced at like 6,500 rupees on Samsung's website. So that itself covers the gap of 7,000 between these two phones, considering the fact that OnePlus 7 Pro doesn't even have a headphone jack or even a Type-C to headphone jack adapter or any pair of Type-C earphones. Now that they have entered the pricing above 50,000, I think that's not where they have to cut corners, at least at this point. That's one of the things I think makes a lot of difference between these two phones now. And the second thing is, the biggest difference is the camera quality. The S10 Plus's cameras, I know, are very consistent compared to the OnePlus 7 Pro. Now, both of them have a very similar setup when it comes to the cameras, but S10 Plus has a little bit wider wide-angle camera at 123 degrees. And its telephoto camera has OIS as well, where a OnePlus phone has only OIS on its main camera. And the software experience also in cameras, HDR and stuff, is a little bit more consistent, and I'd bet my money on the S10 Plus than OnePlus 7 Pro's cameras any day. So the third thing is going to be the official IP rating that Samsung is giving us. It's IP68 dust and water resistant, compared to OnePlus's just word against being water resistant. But yeah, when it comes to water resistance, it's not covered in warranty, I know, but when you know that it's tested against some quality standards and has been issued an IP rating, it's better trusted than OnePlus just coming out and saying, hey, we have equipped your phone with water resistance, but we have not taken certification to save some money for you people. That's just not acceptable. At least at the price of 53,000, I think it's better to go with the S10 Plus for that extra bit of confidence that it's been tested against the IP rating and the certification has been done. So the last but not the least are small things like the Samsung's 60Hz display, which is obviously going to save a lot of battery compared to the 90Hz refresh rate of the OnePlus 7 Pro, which I think feels fluid but is not necessary in a phone that size and what the things you are going to be doing on that. I don't think 90Hz is necessary. So that's one thing. And wireless charging, of course, OnePlus's dash charge is faster than that, but wireless charging is just a neat little thing to have, comparing that the cheap wireless pads cost anywhere around 200 to 300 rupees in the market. I don't see why OnePlus is cutting corners there. So wireless charging is nice to have. Yes, wired charging is faster than that, but wireless charging is nice to have, at least in the premium segment of phones. One thing you constantly see is small things like that matter to you, like at least to boast around your friends. So wireless charging is something you shouldn't skip on, and with wireless charging catching up on all the brands like even Xiaomi, I think OnePlus shouldn't be doing this anymore. And yeah, the extra 100mAh battery that the S10 Plus has also. With the 90Hz refresh rate on the OnePlus 7 Pro, it's going to be draining the 4000mAh battery a lot faster. I've myself seen a lot of speed tests and battery tests on the internet. While the OnePlus 7 Pro, yes, is a little bit faster because of the faster storage, but doesn't last that longer compared to the S10 Plus. Its 4100mAh battery is very optimized with its One UI, so it lasts at least an hour longer with the screen on time under intensive tasks. So if battery life is one of your things, S10 Plus is the way to go. So all these little things add up, and that's what being a flagship is, right? Checking every box and everything. And OnePlus 7 Pro also has Gorilla Glass 5 when S10 Plus comes with the latest Gorilla Glass 6, which is 2 times drop resistant. These are little things, you know, when you're going into a flagship territory and advertising your phone as a flagship, little bit of things matter. You nitpick because you're paying a lot of money for the phone. So these are the things I think more than makes up the gap for 7,000 between these two devices. You guys let me know your opinion in the comment section below. Leave a like if you like the video, and subscribe for more videos like this. See you in the next one.